brother's Omar in the army, you know what I mean? And the thing is that my kids, I just want my rights to see John, and Michael can see me whenever he wants. He's an adult, and he turns 18 in a year from now. And I want my rights to be able to help Michael, because he has now a little bit of a mild post-traumatic stress issue from Jose's, you know, being continual, like, just ignoring his needs, right? You don't participate in the anger that my kids feel from their dad lying to them, and now they're realizing their dad all this time lied to them. I never did drugs. You know, they feel very cheated that they didn't get to have the mom that, you know, worked at the grocery store, and that he embarrassed them in front of their parents, right? On purpose. Like, it was just his rage overflowed into the children. Like, just, I can't even imagine. You would never do that to your wife, even if you're divorced. You wouldn't want your kids to see you're the mom and your kids homeless or walking around with a bag for, you know, 6 years. He did it on purpose. He was making money. He was making money under the table. And he wasn't going to tell the kids, and he wasn't going to tell anybody. He was making a lot of money. None of which I got, and none of which I will ever see. So the $30,000 he has is one of 401k is the only thing that I can get for my children for the future, because he's going to dump them on their butt as soon as they get their 18. He's only making money off of them to begin with, so that's why he got them back. So the thing is that he's over at 44 String Rosier. That house is still over there. I just feel that my girls and boys deserve at least to have a legacy, you know, of a couple of the houses that they own, because they own like 7 houses, you know, and great.